announcement, please turn off your cell phones if the mass is going on, and please take good care of your belongings while inside the church. Thank you.
Thank you. Let us begin in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
With the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit, be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Dearly beloved Don and Cherian, God is love and has, in a mysterious way, drawn you together in love. But he leaves you free to make that love grow or to let it wither and die. The Lord will help you to forge the future for your love if you do your share. When you stand to the commitment to love and honor one another in good times and in bad, in poverty and in plenty, in sickness and in health, for better and for worse, in that covenant which you are about to seal. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest. We bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who in creating the human race willed that man and wife should be one, join, we pray, in a band of inseparable love, these your servants, Don Mir and Chiran, who are to be united in the covenant of marriage, so that as you make their love fruitful, they may become by your grace witnesses to charity itself. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated and listen to the readings.
A reading from the book of Sirach. Happy is the husband of a good wife. The number of his days will be doubled. A loyal wife brings joy to her husband, and he will complete his years in peace. A good wife is a great blessing. She will be granted among the blessings of the man who fears the Lord. Whether rich or poor, his heart is content, and at all times his face is cheerful. A wife's charm delights her husband, and her skill puts flesh on his bones. A silent wife is a gift from the Lord, and nothing is as precious as her self-discipline. A modest wife adds charm to charm, and no scales can weigh the value of her chastity. Like the sun rising in the heights of the Lord, so is the beauty of a good wife in her well-ordered home. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. Our response will be, the earth is full of the goodness of the Lord. Please repeat.
The earth is full of the goodness of the Lord.
They are happy whose God is the Lord, the people he has chosen as his own. The Lord looks on those who revere him, on those who hope in his love.
The earth is full of the goodness of the Lord.
Our soul is waiting for the Lord. The Lord is our help and our shield. In him do our hearts find joy. We trust in his holy name.
The earth is full of the goodness of the Lord.
May your love be upon us, O Lord, as we place all our hopes in you.
The earth is full of the goodness of the Lord. Please God's faith to obtain the holy gospel.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation from the Holy Gospel according to St. John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, as the Father has loved me, so I have loved you. Remain in my love if you keep my commandments. You will remain in my love just as I have kept my Father's commandments and remain in his love. I have told you this so that my own joy may be in you and your joy may be complete. This is my commandment. Love one another as I have loved you. my dear brothers and sisters, the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated for the Holy.
Today we are here to witness the promise of Don Mir and Cherie Ann, a promise to love one another till death do us part, in sickness and in health, in poor and in good times. But what is more challenging in marriage is that it's not the preparation, it's not the rites, but after all of this celebration, the challenge of how are you going to maintain that kind of love, that kind of warm, that kind of understanding, that kind of patience and effort to keep the love between Don Mir and Cherie Ann firing until they grow old together. Yun po ang isa sa mga challenges natin sa mga mag-aasawa. Dahil ang pag-aasawa is not about happiness only. You will also experience challenges in life, whether in terms of your relationship to each other, in terms of your relationship in both sides of their parents and relatives, their brothers and sisters, or challenges between financial aspects, challenges between respect to each other. Lahat ng mga bagay may posibilidad na mangyari at maging dahilan kung saan susubukin ang inyong pagmamahal. Kaya napaka-importante for Don and Cherie Ann yung trust between each other. If you know each other for long, there will be no difficulty of trusting each other. Kung kaya nating magtiwala sa bawat isa at isa, hindi mahirap yung intindihin o kaya nating magparaya para lang intindihin natin ang bawat isa. At the same time, yung bang kahit na meron kang gustong gawin sa buhay, pero dahil mahal mo yung partner mo, mas pipiliin mong suportahan siya para sa kaniyang mga inspiration sa buhay. These are the kind of challenges of being in a marriage life. Yung give and take, yung making sacrifices for your loved ones. Kaya, ang tanong, kayang-kaya ba nating gawin itong mga bagay na ito? Kaya ba nating magsakripisyo para sa ating mahal o sa ating kaparis sa buhay? Kaya ba nating isa lang alang yung ating pangarap sa buhay para lang sa ikakaligaya ng ating partner sa buhay? In this way, we manifest our love to each other through our actions, through our sacrifices, on how we understand each other, on how we support each other, and how we respect each other. Ito yung mga bagay na napaka-importante sa isang mag-asawa. At ito rin yung mga very essential values kung saan, where we keep our love to each other. Yung mga materials na bagay, hindi kuan lang yan, secondary na lang yan. We need that in order that we yung mga bagay na gusto nating magawa. But what is more important is how we establish first that relationship between you, that husband and wife. And if you're able to do that, then at the end you will realize that you are already not just a husband and wife, but you are already building a home where your children, your son and daughter, will also learn the love that you have shared to each other. Ibig sabihin, kayo yung unang mga teacher ng inyong mga maging anak at ituturo niyo sa kanila yung totoong kahulugan ng pagmamahal, yung totoong kahulugan ng pagrespeto, totoong kahulugan ng pag-iintindi sa inyong mahal, sa kaparis sa buhay. At yung ultimate expression of love, inyong kaya mong magsakripisyo para sa ikakasaya ng mahal mo na buhay, sa mahal mo sa buhay. So I hope to Don and Cherry Ann that you continue love each other, continue understanding and understand each other and respect each other. Huwag niyong kalimutan na suportahan ang bawat isa. Kahit gaano man kahirap ang buhay, kahit gaano man kadami yung mga pagsubok sa buhay. At the same time, with the parents of both Don and Cherry Ann, I hope you always be there for them, to guide them. Kasi kayo yung mas nakakaalam sa buhay dahil kayo yung unang naging pamilya, kayo yung unang naging husband and wife. So guide them, ituro nyo sa kanya, sa kanila yung ano yung dahilan, ano yung mga ginagawa nyo kung bakit kayo mismo din nanatiling mahal ninyo ang bawat isa. Diba? At napalaki ninyo inyong mga anak na ganito, mga gwapo at magaganda, mababait at responsable. So you guide them, be a light to them, be an inspiration to them as they begin their new life as husband and wife.
For the right of marriage, giving hold again the sponsor to be slightly ended, the time I ask the parents to attend the sponsor to be slightly ended, the leader said it's a
My dear friends, you have come together so that the Lord may seal and strengthen your love in the presence of Christ and His Church. Christ abundantly blesses this love. He has already consecrated you in baptism, and now He enriches and strengthens you by a special sacrament so that you may assume the duties of marriage in mutual and lasting fidelity. And so, in the presence of the Church, may I now ask you to answer truthfully the following questions.
Yes, Father.
Chirion, did you come here of your own free will to bind yourself forever in the love and service of your husband?
Yes, Father.
Don Mayor,
yes,
did
Father.
You come here of your own free will to bind yourself forever in the love and service of your wife?
Yes, Father.
To both of you, are you ready to raise as good Christians the children whom God will give you?
Yes, Father.
Yes, Father.
Don and Chirion, since you wish to contract matrimony, holy matrimony, please join your right hands and express your intention before God and His church. Chirion, do you take Don Mir, your present, for your lawful husband, according to the rite of our Holy Mother, the Church?
Yes, I do.
Do you give yourself to him as his wife?
Yes, I do.
Do you accept him as your lawful husband?
Yes, I do.
Don Mir, do you take Chirion, her present, for your lawful wife, according to the rite of our Holy Mother, the Church?
Yes, I do.
Do you give yourself to her as your husband?
Yes, I do.
Do you accept her as your lawful wife?
Yes, I do.
Now, let's see together.
Grant us, O Lord, to be one heart and one soul from this day forward, for better or for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, until death do us part.
And I, by the authority of the Church, calling on all those present here as witnesses, confirm and bless the bond of marriage which you have contracted. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Don Mir and Chirion, we shall now bless your aura and rings. Bless, O Lord, your servant, Don Mir and Chirion, with sufficiency of material possessions, which this aura symbolizes, so that they may use them to attain eternal life. Lord, bless this ring and grant those who wear them may always have a deep faith in each other. May they do your will and always live together in peace, goodwill, and love. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Balik mo muna yun doon. Balik. Dito mo lang.
The wedding ring is the outward and visible sign of a spiritual bond which unites two loyal hearts. It is a seal of the vows which you, Don Mir and Chirion, have made. Now give this rings to one another and say,
Chirion, wear this ring as a sign of my love and loyalty. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Don Mayor D, wear this ring as a sign of my love and loyalty. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
I give you this ara as a pledge of my dedication to your welfare. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
And I accept them.
Sige po, labag.
Please. So congratulations to Don and Mayor, and let us give applause to both of them.
Please all stand.
Dear beloved, let us now pray for the church and for our newly wed couple whose marriage reflects our union with Christ. Let our response be, Lord, graciously hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. Lord, graciously hear us.
For the delivered couple, that God may take your heart tonight and forever, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, graciously hear us.
That He may protect them from evil, like in their darkness and fortify them in their trials, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, graciously hear us.
That He may renew the grace of the sacrament of the marriage couple in present, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Almighty eternal God, look down with favor upon your servants, Don Mayor and Chirian. Grant them to remain faithful to you and to one another. And at the end of a long and well-spent life, reward them with eternal happiness, together with their children and with all those who love them. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated. May we call the sponsor to this place the veil of the living and man, and the Lord sponsors the Eucharist customary.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for good and good of all church.
Receive, we pray, O Lord, the offering made on the occasion of this sealing of the secret bond of marriage, and as just as your goodness it is its origin, mere providence guide its course. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is so right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you have forged the covenant of marriage as a sweet yoke of harmony and unbreakable bond of peace, so that chaste and fruitful love of holy matrimony may serve to increase the children you adopt as your own. By your providence and grace, O Lord, you accomplish the wonder of this twofold design, that while the birth of children brings beauty to the world, their birth in baptism gives increase to the church through Christ our Lord. Through him, with the angels and all the saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please all kneel. What's in the book of God?
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like a dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please understand
the mystery of faith. Therefore, as we now celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, and also our bishop and all the clergy. Be mindful also, Lord, of Don Mayor and Chirian, whom you have brought to their wedding day, so that by your grace they may be abide in mutual love and in peace. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse, with the blessed apostles, Saint Augustine, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we merit to be co-heirs of eternal life, and we praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Let us pray to the Lord for his bride and groom, Don Mir and Chirian, who come to the altar as they begin their marriage life, that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, they may always be bound together by love for one another. Holy Father, maker of the whole world, who created men and women in your own image, and will that their union be crowned with your blessing, we humbly beseech you for these your servants who are joined today in the sacrament of matrimony. May your abundant blessing, Lord, come down upon this bride, Chirian, and on her companion for life, and may the power of the Holy Spirit set their hearts aflame from on high, so that living out together the gift of matrimony, may they enrich the church. In happiness, may they praise you, Lord, in sorrow, may they seek you out. May they have the joy of your presence to assist them in their toil, and know that you are near to comfort them in their need. Let them pray to you in the Holy Assembly and bear witness to you in the world and after a happy old age, together with the circle of friends that surrounds them. May they come to the kingdom of heaven through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be with you.
People will be my peace.
to. Wherever you die, I shall die. And there shall I be buried beside you. We will be together.
Let us pray. Having been partakers at your table, we pray, O Lord, that those who are united by the sacrament of marriage may always hold fast to you and proclaim your name to the world. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Don Mayor and Chirian, now that you have received the holy sacrament of matrimony, I admonish you to remain faithful to one another. Chirion, love your husband and be a good housewife. Persevere in faith and love and holiness. Don Mir, love your wife as Christ loved his church and live with her in the holy fear of the Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the God of powerful Father grant you his joy, bless you in your children.
Amen.
May the only begotten Son of God stand by you with compassion in good times and in bad.
Amen.
May the Holy Spirit of God always pour forth his love into your hearts.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless you all who are gathered here, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass has been offered. Go in peace. Glorify the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
So for final expression of love of Don and Mir, so we may now see a kiss of both of them.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
For a thousand years, I love you for a thousand.